Right, so tonight I guess I could talk about opera and what I'm doing, where I'm going with it. I have my compilation. There are 40 songs around that I sing, but I've dropped some and I've not been étudiant with. Shame on me, but I can't really focus on all of them at once, you know. So I've dropped that one, oh, Dolce Mio Dor, that one. Dolce. See what I mean? I dropped it. I completely even forgot the title. Oh, Dolce di Antaradietta, that one. And then I'm like, well, that's okay. And I dropped Eben Lontano, which is a bummer because that's a good one. It has the newbie, the newbie part, and a lot of that golden ore and whatever. But yeah, I can't. When I'm going through all of these songs, I get to that section, and I have a choice. I have Ecco, Respiro, or I have the Povieri. Or the Eben, and I'm never singing the Eben, so I'm just sorry, Eben. Way back, in the La Traviatas, I'm even lagging, seriously lagging in my Estrono, my Misterioso, because I haven't really found great, start music with it. I've found some, but it's you know it's not the greatest funnest intro for Estrono, so I haven't really been doing my Estrono. I haven't been doing my Misterioso, Delicioso. When I'm in that Misterioso one. There's no way, because once I'm getting to the end, it has an escalade moment, and another escalade moment before it jumps into the folly, and I can't find that on any tape out here. So they're missing that last final bit of wind. So it's not a fun song to sing. Caballé sings it very well on those final steps. See where was I at? So yeah, so I'm lacking in that one. I never really what was the other one that I dropped that one. There's a few I have dropped. I haven't been singing at all. No patrimonio, no, none of that. I couldn't focus on them. They weren't flowing easy with just the orchestra, you know, you're singing with the orchestra only. But yeah, they weren't flowing with, so I just dropped them. My pace, I dropped. So, in my Verdis, I have very, very few. I do have one of those caronomes, if I work on it, and I have what do you call it? Like I said, the Ecco Respiro, and the Povieri Fiori. And then I'm like, well, are those Verdis? Maybe not. Maybe they're somebody else's. But I put them at the end, so they're kind of like Verdis. My Adeo, you know, when you're like, I know, dying at the end of La Traviata. That one I do work on occasionally. I head back to the very beginning, though. I'm running in differently. Normally, in the old days, in my training by myself, I ran through the hypey songs first, everything high, and then I worked down into the deeper voice. But now I just don't care anymore. And so I'm just starting with all of the Bellini. I start with the vocalizé pretty much, and that my gosh, where's my list? Yeah, where's my list? I sing it like all the time. But Crepuscule, that one. And then I do teeter on the Lac Mai Belle clochette. I do that one, and then I head to that Quante Volte, which I probably would be told a million times, you don't have the voice for that one, you're too heavy for Quante Volte, but it's supposed to be lighter, and, you know, like Desse is so light and flies with it. But too bad. For me, it's my medicine song. I have to sing it. So it's like a medicine song. If you have one of those in your whatever you call it, this rehearsals for years and years. I remember way back in France, when I really first started singing, I was like, my mom had just died, and I was like, well, now what am I going to do? And she's not even going to hear me sing, you know, it was just awful. So in a way, it was like a strange, like, I'm going to sing, maybe she'll hear me still, you know, they hear that, they have that, the spirit world, and the moms go around the planet after, you know, they die, and they're in their spirit, so maybe she'll hear me singing, you know, they have all those weird esoterical things. And so I'm like, well, I can maybe tap through, you know, that way. Because I really miss my mom. She was my chauffeur. She was my best friend. She was just great. She was a great lady. And she was my arts helper. You know, she brought me to ballet. She brought me to the theater. She was my manager. She was just my pusher, you know what I mean? She pushed me into the arts. And so then when I was there, you know, singing in France, you know, I'm thinking about it, I was so obnoxious, really, in the beginning. I was so obnoxious singing Carmen's and all of this stuff. And I don't know if I've gotten, I hope I've gotten some obnoxiousness gone since then. Loud, obnoxious. I was too loud, you know what I mean? Like, I lived on the farm. I had a farm house situation. We had a huge pond. Huge, huge pond. And I guess I scared every fox away. I scared every weasel. There was never any trouble. And the ducks at night, you know, I'd be in the upstairs. They would be out looking. They'd be out on the grass. And they would sleep in formation. They would sleep like with their, they'd have their tails, one tail this way and another tail that way, and another, exactly like geometric formations, and so these would be on starry nights, and it's almost like they were really trying to link up with the stars in space, and it's just the cutest thing, and in a way not just cute, it was more like. They were contacting out there, I swear. They were like contacting something out there, like some planet was theirs that they talked to or they rearranged with, you know. They set their timer. But yeah. So that's a thing, like when you first start out singing, it's that uncontrolled, that wild, that boisterousness. And in a way, you know, that's a terrible thing to do because it's so decadent that it, you know, strains the chords and probably creates all kinds of trouble in there, and gravel stones or whatever, in the throat. But that's the eagerness of beginning, isn't it? You know, you get really like, yeah. And now I've been singing so long, I've gone back into. Many times I just try to sing quiet. Yeah, quiet. And so then, okay, so where am I? Back to my songs. Oh yeah, I go through my list. After Quante Volte, I hit with Col Sorizo. Then I head to chi not vocale spedi. Come on, I can't even think of it right now. Oh my gosh, I used to have like a board. It had all my songs on it, and I don't have it anymore. And it was very helpful. Qui la voce, that one. Then I go to Casta Diva. Then I go to that sad one, Solo Duro. Which one is that one called? I don't know, that one. And then I'm done with Bellini. And I do not go towards the Cara Compagna. Unfortunately, I'm not that excellent at it, because you need a good, I think the only ones I found were piano, and I just couldn't get in there, and I couldn't get into the piano ones. I have very few songs that are piano only, and for some reason I can sing them, but when you put piano on some of the others, I can't sing them, so it's a weird voice that I have. It's preferential to orchestra, and doesn't want piano all the time. But like Sposa Disprezzata loves the piano. I love the piano on that one. That one's fine. And so you never know. You never know why. Because maybe that one is like really difficult for somebody. And yet for me it's really easy. I don't understand how voices work. I can warm it up and warm it up and warm it up. I still don't understand how it works. It's just like a mystery to me how it just all of a sudden starts singing. It's incredible. It really is incredible. So then after the Bellinis, I've been skipping over Carmen. Sorry about that. I'm skipping over Carmen. Then I go to, I don't know, I had to Mozart, but it's sometimes, I don't know. I have Achik Liebte, which is my high force. I force myself up there. Then I get back, I can do the Vedre, what's that one, Carino? What's that? Yeah, I think it's Vedre Carino. My Doviason, I've left for about a month. Then I have Porgy Moore. That one's getting better. I have Achik Fools. That one's pretty easy. But not with the piano. So that one is definitely an orchestra. I try it with... There was one I tried today with the piano only. Oh, and my voice, it just... Oh, the vocalise. I can do that one. But my voice gets real timid and tiny, and it's just like, where's the cello? It kind of starts yelling at me, where's the cello? And I can't get that oomph, you know. It's almost like, it's not a stage fright or a stage fear. The voice just doesn't want to, it's strange, because it's like when the cello is there with the orchestra, it's easier. It just is easier, because it becomes a compliment moment. And I guess I need that in my ear, my inner ear, to hear where to put the depth, and where to put the shallow, and where to put, you know, all of that, more rich or less rich, you know. So that if you don't have, yeah, I mean, it's incredible. Some women can do this with just the piano. In some of these songs, they're just amazing. So, yeah, so that one's a toughie for me. I can do the vocalise on the piano only, but it starts to feel rinky-dink, you know. I like it with the cello. It's beautiful. Okay, so then, but I went back. I know this piano thing is really, really, really my torture, isn't it? Oh, my Colt Sorriso is on the piano only. So there you go. So there. So yeah, I may have already said this, but I get excited when I have at least something on the piano, you know, as a success that I feel like I've accomplished, and I don't sound like a wacko. So then then, here I'm at the Mozart land, I made it through. Sometimes Voce Sapete, I do that one, which is that one where she's like the woman who is the man, the ultra mezzo, the dress up like the boy, that one, yeah. Voce Sapete, I just sang, so I'm kind of... then what else? When we head to... I'm going through, and I've been leaving all of my Pergolozzi style till the very end now. I've been putting them at the end. It's more like the warm downs. So that's my Spozza, my Vise d'Arte, not the Vise d'Arte, the other one, the Spozza, Son Disprezzata. I leave till the end, and I have my Vidit Sum at the end. And sometimes I do that other one at Gementum, and the Ombre Mai Fu, of course, I do that one sometimes. But I'm trying to leave those closer to the end. Now, the drama next is, I have a lot of Puccinis, and a lot of Puccinis. I love Puccini, actually, it's great. And then we have I don't have any Rossinis, I'm sorry. I tried, I did not. I have Rusalka, and I love Rusalka, and I make up the words because I can't find the pronunciation, but it's wonderful, I love Rusalka. And that one is with the orchestra, sounding, recording. And so then when I'm at the la 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 la, the end with the moon, I love it, how it winds. See, look at that, something's dropping off the shelf, it's so excited also. All right, okay, now back to Puccini. Okay, I've been starting with O Mio Bambino, then I head, sometimes if it's a spring day, is feeling like spring, I'll do Si mi ci amano, Mimi, then Donde lieta, then I will head back into In che altrine morbide, then big decision, am I gonna sing Butterfly? Because if I sing Vedremo, if I sing that one, well, that puts me out, I can't sing a lot of things after that. Then I go to Vise d'Arte, I go to Signora Soccolta, I go to Tucce di Gel Sicinta, then I head all the way, because I've dropped my Senza Mamma for a while, I just don't have time for her, and so I head all the way then to, what is that one? Verdi style, the last of the concerto style, so I head over there to my Ecco, Respiro and my Adeo and Fovieri Fiori, and then go back to Pergolozzi's to close. So it's like that's been working, and I think, I don't know, maybe it's like 15-20 arias sometimes, and I've been pacing myself, I've been doing this for years, and I still think I have a voice, I still think I'm improving, so I think it's a technique that works. However, I cannot do it every day. I can only maybe 3 days in a row, then I have to take off, and then another 3 days in a row, and then take off. So it does work, because it is an hour and a half. And sometimes I'll sneak into two, you know. So because it's that many songs, it's exhausting. I'm exhausted. My legs are exhausted. I am physically exhausted. It's a lot of breath different in the lungs. Singing is a lot of different breath in the lungs, isn't it? And I believe it sets a different tempo with us, a different tempo with how we talk to people, how we meet people, how we relate with people. I think it just affects everything, because our breathing, our momentum is different in this carriage of our ribs, you know, our upper back, our lower back, and all that expansionism. We're almost like, when you think about it, you know, they have these guys, these people that live in somewhere out there in Indonesia in the water, and they live like under the water, like a lot of the time. They go down there and they breathe for like minutes and minutes and minutes and minutes and time, and swim. And of course they use them for the pearl diving and gathering of fish for many years, but they're like almost like a different species of human, because they breathe differently. They breathe in so much oxygen and they hold it so long that they are, they're just like, talk about another wavelength, really another wavelength. So anyway, so that's my diarrhea that I'm doing there. And my karonomi, I used to force that one in the beginning, because karonomi is a high, but I'm not. I've been trying to sneak in karonomi after like an akik fools, around the time of akik lipte, because that one is so high. So I like to keep the highs together. But yikes. Yikes. So yeah, I hate missing songs. I used to sing more, of course, because it was a sing-along time type for a while. But now I'm just all on my own. So it is freeing. It's a wonderful and freeing. But yeah. It's wonderful and freeing to not you know, hear, you know, the helper diva. But I miss them. Of course, I miss them still. And I've been watching them out here on the internet again, and going, oh my gosh, they do so many things. You know, they do tricks. They don't do tricks. They do all kinds of things. They're amazing. And I am just, sometimes I feel like I'm just going through the motions of singing compared to them. But as time goes on, maybe I am amazing to someone. I don't know. Maybe I'm amazing to myself. Maybe that's more important. You know what I mean? So, yeah. And no, I'm not painting. I'm not doing any drawing. I'm not doing any artistry right now. I can't right now. My dad is just really kind of, he's busy in his life, being in this new town. And I have, you know, I have to, I don't have to, I can't, you know, get down to artwork right now, darn it. I did see lots of butterflies today. We have swallowtails, we have, and I feel like maybe I'm cheating them, because I put the flowers back there. Maybe they're attracted, they think there's another, like a mate. Maybe I'm cheating the butterflies. You know, maybe they're not going to find a mate, because they found there's flowers there. And they thought, well, I thought you were one, you know. The whole thing about, you know, we try to attract them to our gardens with all of these plants, all these flowers. I hope they don't get confused, you know. I hope they don't get confused. That, to me, would be the worst. Yeah. Anyway, so I have two rose bushes that are working, the Proud Land and the Peace. I got the Angel Face and she died. I had an Angel Face rose bush and it just died like within the first 3 or 4 days. It just did not transplant at all. And that was the one I really, really wanted. It was one of my favorite colors, but just decided to up and go. So I took it back to the store. I dug it up and took it back to the store, and that was kind of interesting. The woman was okay. She took it back, but yeah, I also took back some old blackberry twigs. They sell those twigs. Two of them failed, and a raspberry twig failed. So, and I got replacements, but oh my gosh, funny. It's funny to do that, to take back the old plants that didn't make it. Anyway, enough of that store. I cannot go shopping there for like maybe a year. I went there so many times to buy garden things and more garden things and more garden things. I don't ever want to go shopping again. So, yeah. Anyway, sing a song. So that's where I'm at. And I'm sorry. I cannot turn on this vocalizer and make it work. I don't know if it's Ubuntu, just doesn't want to work with me, or I just don't have a recordable voice. I don't know. It doesn't matter. It's what I do. And no, I don't have a sweet voice like Mariah Carey, darn it. And I'm thinking about that. That sweet, beautiful. That style. I do not have that. That airy, light. Yeah, just a heavy, and trying not to drone. All right. Yeah, because if you drone into the song, it starts to become like, well, that's boring, isn't it? And you made it boring. Yeah. Anyway. Yeah. I'm watching the master classes. What else can I do? Observance. When I sing, I cannot be wearing rough clothing. I don't understand the reason, but it hurts me. I am like really, really sensitive ever since France. I don't know if it was the nuclear or whatever, but my skin is very sensitive to the touch. I can't even be wearing a t-shirt and sing. It has to be something very, very soft. It has to be chenille. Has to be velvet, has to be something like that, or I'm doomed. So yeah, I guess I could have been exposed. Anyway, maybe it is the sensitivity of the songs themselves. They force that out, and my skin becomes more sensitive. Yeah, nothing rough. No rough allowed. And I have to wear high heels. So all of these are like little weirdo things. I don't have to always wear high heels, of course, but for when I do a whole bunch of songs, it just makes for the event. Yeah, it's very serious. Singing is very serious. All right, guys, I hope you have something that you do also that's very serious.